This is a very special night for me, as this is the episode one of Direct Talk. Press start and credits. With my man, the General Johnson, my brother, Tashawn. This is official. I'm glad we have come together to make this thing happen. And I think we got something very, very good going on with this. So I decided to keep it going with him, add him addition to the show. And I want you guys to be honest and let us know what you think. Our goal is to deliver great Xbox news, give you positive content, and edify the Xbox community, man, one that we enjoy being a part of. So to all my comrades around the globe, this is the new legal, rocking with my man, the General. And let's get this started. Direct talk, press start, and credits. How you feeling tonight, General?
What's going on, baby? What's going on? Xbox is good all the time. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We're going to get this Crackdown, man. I'm going to represent Crackdown tonight. I feel like, you know what, Crackdown 3 will not be a disappointment. So I'm going to represent some Crackdown. It's out. You guys can get it, along with it being an enhanced game. So I can't wait to play this as we talk and do this thing live and direct. Like I say, the vision of this channel is to incorporate the virtual arcade game room where the community of gamers come together and talk about what we like to talk about, no other than gaming. So Live came about in 2001 and made this thing right here possible. And we're very grateful and humble to have this platform where we can do what we always do, get into a party and just rock out, man, on a favorite subject of ours, and that's Xbox. So let's get it, y'all, and let's get it popping. It's Crackdown. It's Direct Talk. So, General, I got some news today, man, Microsoft has trademarked something similar to like a editor, like a movie editor, man, where you can chop things down. I put it like this, something like Upload Studios, but more sophisticated. And I don't really know what the name of it was, man.
Mix editor.
It's a mix editor? Is that what it was called?
Yes, as far as, you know, going along with Mixer, what you do along with Mixer, but it's called mix editor. It sounds incredible, man. It sounds incredible.
Yo, that's crazy because now, you know what I'm saying, it can be automatic because the Mixer is so easy and so smooth as it is, man. I like the way the Mixer operates to be able to edit your videos now, show some, you know, the favorite clips that you want to show, get down to the fine ingredients of what you want to deliver, and man, make your video more personal. I think that's great. And if Microsoft made that their own, then that's just off the chain, man. That means now they can control whatever they want, whenever they want, and how they want to add and subtract to any features that they feel like can build up the broadcast. The broadcasting universe. People who like to stream and broadcast, man. That'll be good for them.
Yeah. I mean, like I was saying, you know, we was talking a little bit. Microsoft, they see something and they make it their own. And I always try to tell Xbox gamers that because Microsoft wants to appeal to everybody. There's a difference to what they're doing now, man. I see a lot of people, wondering, what's with the platformers and, you know, Super Lucky Tales and things like that. They want to appeal to kids and adults, and they want to appeal to everybody, man. They want to be a more mainstream system. So with the Mixer and the mix editor and being unique and being innovative, I always say Microsoft is so innovative. They always have been. And so basically, just put it right in our laps, you know what I mean?
Right, they put it right there, and it's like, you don't get it at first, but then a couple years down the road, you get it, and then it's like a couple years down the road, everybody wants to start following.
Exactly. So it's like, you know, Microsoft, they're really, you know, I love the fact that Phil Spencer and them, and Aaron and Mike Jabara, just all of them over there, they have such a vision. And I love the fact that they're pushing the industry forward. Yes, you know, everybody just kind of want to stick to the same old thing, right? Where it's the big $60 exclusive title, you know, it's coming out this fall. Microsoft is trying to give you more, like more for your buck and more control. And what's this thing about, you know, sharing the controller? You know, I think you can give somebody the controller. Why, you know, you got a mixer game going or something. Like, that's innovative. Like, it's insane.
Yeah, man, you know, it's a good thing that you brought up that Xbox is pushing the envelope because my man J-Long today was talking about how it seems like Microsoft is being risky. You know what I'm saying? While everybody else is, like, scared to play their hand, and Microsoft is coming out here all hands on deck and just really trying to push gaming forward, man. And you just it just looks and seems like it, man. And it's almost to the point where it's obvious.
It is. It is. And the thing that people don't understand is that Microsoft, man, they just want to have their own thing, you know? Like, you know, people got to understand, right? Just, you know, flexibility. Every system has to be different. Every system has to be different. In other words, why would you pick up the system, right? The Switch got its own thing. They got its own gimmick or niche or whatever you want to call it, right?
Right.
And then Sony got their thing. You know, they got the VR, you know, going and, the big blockbuster. A lot of single player,
man, that's for sure. Yeah, that's for sure, man.
Microsoft has multiplayer. They got the mixer. They are the kings. I'm talking like Coming to America, King Joffrey Joseph. They're the kings of backwards compatibility right now.
Yeah,
the
you kings. Know what, man? Another thing, you know, the fact
nobody,
that, you know.
Nobody talks about that. They are the kings of backwards compatibility. Like, yo, Turok just dropped, yo.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh, my gosh, man.
Yeah, that's true. You know, it's another thing that you said, man, you know, about the multiplayer, but. You know, it's like Microsoft gives you that single-player experience. They just always seem to make sure that they deliver that co-op feeling because, man, they don't want to sit there and you just, you know, get in a game and you only play it by yourself. I mean, come on, you know.
Yeah, that's true.
The main thing about gaming, man, is community, right? So why wouldn't you want to be a part of community?
Yeah, but sometimes, man, you know, when you look at the numbers, you know, I'm being kind of sarcastic here. When you look at the numbers, it just seems like a lot of people want to sit there and drink a Monster Energy drink, and they want to, you know, put on their headset, they want to play by themselves. You know what I'm saying? Because all these, a lot of titles, they sell, right? But the fact is, what's genius on Microsoft is that Microsoft makes you keep playing the game, man.
You know
what I mean? They keep you inside the loop. Like, it's so much content. If I was to load a Halo 5 right now and say, you know what? If I want to try the multiplayer, I could be on it all night. There's so many modes. It's the Warzone. There's all type of stuff. You know what I mean? They brought back old modes that, you know, made it better and stuff like that. So, Microsoft, they understand that they offer Xbox Live and that they are going to do what they need to do to make sure that you are part of Xbox Live. And Xbox Live is the breathing heart of, you know, the Xbox One or the Xbox itself. And a lot of people don't understand that. Like, that's the community. You know what I mean? That's the community. When Sea of Thieves come out, I can't wait, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
To be on a boat with you. You know what I mean? I'm going to customize my pirate and we can go, you know, treasure hunting and shoot sharks and whatever. Get into some sword fights, man. Like, that's stuff you can't do on the other, you know, platforms. So,
right.
You know, but Microsoft, man, they just ahead of the game, man.
Yeah, I'm about. It's getting to where it's getting obvious now about Microsoft, man, wanting to push that envelope.
Oh yeah. Yeah. And that's what I love about Microsoft, man, is that they're trying to innovate the industry. You know what I mean? They're trying to do something different. I just think gamers, man, they kind of get like, you know, they kind of get like any phone, right?
Right.
You know, they say as you get older, you get stuck in your ways.
Right.
Against that. But, hey, man, I remember when they told us we're going to need broadband, and everybody was mad. Like, yo, I got my dial-up. You trying to take my AOL away from me?
Right, right.
All broadband, just like they told us we would. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, you know, I remember the first time on the 360, DLC. We was like, what's that?
Yep.
And I remember content. It was all so new, and that was just the norm. I mean, I just saw the Super Lucky Tales got DLC. A whole nother section to play.
A whole nother island.
I'm like, yo. And I'm trying to beat the regular story. That's great that game is getting extra content. Because, you know, for any kid that loves Super Lucky Tales, well, now, you know,
yeah, they can get back on it. Yeah, they can get back on it. And that's that replay value. That's that replay value that you was just talking about. And, you know, back to the news, because this Microsoft, to me, man, is just killing it with the news right now, man. Back to that. What was the other thing that happened this week, man? Like, it was two big things that happened this week.
What happened this week? Let me see. Oh, man, I know. Well, you got Mix Editor.
Yeah, you got the Mix Editor. It was one more thing that happened
today.
They
basically gave it a new visual engine. They even added some stuff, some extra bosses, and added some extra levels. So it's kind of like you're getting a brand new Turok game in a way. It looks more polished, you know, than it was. And I believe it has the Xbox One X enhancement treatment. So, and then of course, you know, Crackdown. And let me say this: for anybody that's a hardcore gamer, you know. Everybody that really claim they're a hardcore gamer, put Crackdown on the hardest level and watch you go crying to your mama.
Man, that Crackdown on a hard level, man, is insane. I'm not even gonna go back through that. I'm not gonna do that no more.
It's insane.
Yeah,
man.
You do that one time, exactly.
Stuff that come out, but I love the fact they put this game out, man, because it really reminds you, like, okay. For somebody who never played this game before, this is a great game. This is a great game.
Yeah, I'm doing the checkpoints right now. I'm just doing the checkpoints, man.
Yeah. The video games were made to shoot and blow stuff up. That's how it always been. From going back to Atari with combat, and, you know what I mean, and Space Invaders. And,
right.
You know, I know I'm showing my age, but I don't care, man. He's a classic, man. You know what I'm saying? Even Dick Dug, man, when you took the little... You know, the little vacuum, and you had to pump up the dragon's stomach and all these little beasts. It was always about shooting and blowing stuff up and having fun. Well, that's Crackdown. Like my man Terry Crews said, get your boom on, man.
That's
you know
it,
what I'm
man.
Don't blow something up, man.
That's right, man. That's right. Yeah. I forgot what the other news was, man. That's killing me. That's killing me right now, man. It was one more thing that Microsoft did this week that got me, man, that and I can't remember what it was.
Wow.
I can't remember what it was, man. But yeah, I think it had to do with...
A lot of news came out. That's a great thing.
Yeah, a lot of news came out, man. I think the backwards compatibility being enhanced, that was one of them. But it wasn't so significant as what I'm really thinking about. What Microsoft is trying to implement, man, is the universal aspect of its ecosystem. And I think that they're moving in the right direction now, bringing all the elements to the game. Because you think about it, man, we already can game share. We already have a feature now like Twitch. We're getting our own editing, video editing back. And way better than Upload Studios. We're getting that's what it was. The other one, here's the news. The big news was when Game Pass permanently. There we go. I did it. I finished up my laps. But
all right.
But when Game Pass, man, made the first party games permanent now. So you think about that. Anytime that you get a anytime that was big. Anytime that you get a first party game now, you know it's automatically coming out on Game Pass. You don't have to worry about nothing.
Exactly.
You and just taking care of. Yup, you just took care of all the people who can't get day one purchases, and you just made it possible. You made it you made it a lot easier, hell of a lot easier. Yep.
I mean, they understand, man, that the industry is changing, and honestly, man, you know, a lot of these developers, man, they don't, like, people don't want to believe it, you know, because they see that Mario, you know, Odyssey did 9 million, and Horizon Zero Dawn is 7.6 million, but it's not enough, man. I'm not trying to hate, but when you're a developer, and you got 70 million console install base, 7.6 million, that's not really a lot. Depending what the budget of the game was, but Microsoft understands that the big $60 title is going away. They understand that.
Right.
They understand that this industry is going somewhere else. And they want to be the one to lead it. They want to be the one to lead it. They want to be able to do something that's different. But they really are right now, man. So, I would say fanfare. You know, like, think about it, man. If somebody, you know, mama, go buy their kid an Xbox One, man, for $10, it's what, over 100 games now, something like that. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And it does hurt retail, but the developers, man, they don't really want nothing to do with retail. Because the situation like Game Pass, developers get the money now. And that's why retail is angry. That's why retail is not happy with Microsoft right now. As somebody said at one store, oh, well, they just really messed up our Xbox business. Yeah, but you're selling their games. But use price, you're taking their games used, and they're not getting the money. You're getting the money. So, Game Pass is a game changer, man. It's a game changer.
It is, man. And you want to know something else?
I love it.
What I like is the fact that Microsoft, with the purchases of these games, man, and these games being cheaper than what they would normally be, man, that's a game changer. And honestly, man, to not even be funny, Microsoft been doing that. You remember them with the TK series, man? They had that football game retailing at $19.99. It's not nothing unusual for Microsoft to go with a cheaper price when it comes to their video games, man, because they've always made sure that their audience would get the most out of their gaming. That's what it was, man. It wasn't about it. It's not about the individual hardware aspect of their business. They like the software side of things. So anytime So anytime they can make it off of software, that's what they're gonna push.
Right.
They're not pushing for the hardware. So when you hear people talk about individual units with Microsoft, You gotta laugh at them because, the reason why we crack up when we do it is because we know that if Microsoft is killing it with the hardware aspect, then we automatically know that they're good with their software aspect. That's why we trip. You know what I'm saying? That's why we trip because we're like, wow, it's one thing to dominate your software, but it's another thing to dominate both. And when Microsoft can dominate both, that's impressive.
I mean, check this out, man. They put out a $500 system in November, right?
Right.
And, you know, more powerful, way more powerful, even more impressive, the way they're doing, backwards compatibility. Like, man, backwards compatibility is getting Xbox One and X enhancements. Like, crap now looks great, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, it looks really good, man. Compared to, you know, what you actually get for the 360 version and stuff. But it's like, man, like, they had their best January, if you want to go about the NPDs and things like that. ever. They said ever. That means over, even when the 360 was so dominant. So all they know now is the content. I'm telling you, at E3, they're going to make Miles drop. And people don't understand. And the one thing I understand is this. I'll tell you this, man, Dorian. Yeah, a good game is a good game. I don't care if it's double A.
True.
I don't care if it's AAA. A good game is a good game.
True. It's always been that way.
I think that we have this culture where it's like, oh, well, if it's not AAA, it's not good. No, that's ignorance. Because a good game is a good game, you know? We have to understand that Microsoft is looking at a different direction. They want to provide more. They want to provide more variety. They don't just want to provide Halo Gears and Halo Gears. And nothing wrong with Halo Gears. Just Microsoft gets it, like, they want to do some different stuff, man.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, but Microsoft always been creative, man. Crackdown 3. Yeah, wait till that multiplayer. That's going to make people miles drop. When you're running around and you're shooting stuff, you know, y'all hunting each other down, and you can blow up buildings and lamp posts.
Doing it already, man. Having a blast already.
All because of Azure, man. All because they're going to show that cloud power.
Yeah, the Azure is about to act up. Yeah, the Azure is about to act up. The Azure, as we would say.
Rome wasn't making a dent.
That's true. That's true.
I think Xbox fans need to understand that, man. Like, I just think a lot of, I recently heard not a podcast, but it was a little recording. My man was talking about how he's overhearing that Microsoft is, you know, they want to put more female characters in their games. What was wrong with that? Look at Hollywood right now, man. Like, females are really a thing now, and you know, and I mean, I even heard something as ignorant as somebody said, well, they're only bringing Perfect Dark back because they want more female characters. No, Perfect Dark is a classic franchise, man. And for us to have that in third person with some stealth action and you know what I mean, and that futuristic crime saga world, that's going to be nuts, man. Nuts. And the Coalition is doing it. Game over.
Yeah, that's true.
You know what I'm saying? So I just think that Microsoft, man, they fought this whole PR thing. You know, they've been really fighting this dinosaur since 2013. Nobody wants to let it go. People talk about it every day. And I heard somebody say something that was really cool. He was an Xbox fan. And he was like, yo, man, like, he was like, man, Microsoft is doing a great job, man. But every time you turn around, the media, he said, even a bunch of sour Xbox fans, he kind of really kept it honest, man. He said, all you're doing is talking about the negative, man. Like, what about the good stuff that they do?
Yeah, because, a lot of folks, man, are not really true Xbox fans, man.
Yeah, they're not.
They're YouTubers. And when YouTubers, that's different from people that actually play these games, man. So, you got to understand.
I'm gonna put a dollar in the collection plate on that one, because you are absolutely telling the truth.
That's what it is, man. You can't get mad at people because of they just want to yap about this industry. Well, I mean, anybody can yap about this industry. That ain't my cup of tea, man. My boy Chris Dove was saying, K-Dove was saying something to me the other day, and it had to do with these frame rates and you know, resolution and frame rates. And he was know what, man? On the real, and counting frame rates, you know, and worrying about... You know, we never did no stuff like that, man. All that kind of talk, that's article talk. That's people who like to read stuff and you know, get a kick out of all the politics about gaming. I'm not into the politics about gaming. I could care less.
But see, that's what I hate about...
I'm playing Crackdown right now. You think I'm caring about the frame rate and how it's looking and all this stuff? Nah, man, I'm playing Crackdown because it's fun.
Yeah, I just think that, see, you just nailed it on the head, real soft, man. Salute to you. I think that the fact that gaming has become politics is really bad. You know what I'm saying? But I mean, I'm not gonna get into that. But I'm just saying, Microsoft is doing so many great things, man. They really are, man. I just think that people are seeing them going in a different direction, and it makes them nervous. You know what I'm saying? They're so used to these, shall we say, adult, gritty games, and
love it.
Over the top, you know, Michael Bay, you know, action graphics, and but it's like, yo, they do that and y'all don't buy them. That's what pisses me off.
You can't, like, can't expect casuals to buy games like that, man. You can't expect.
I'm talking about the hardcore. I'm being real. Like, Microsoft brings you different stuff and you don't support it. It brings you the stuff you're used to and you go support it. And that's the problem with, I think, the Xbox community. I'll give you an example. I'll give you a pure example. Sunset Overdrive did 1.2 million. That game is too good to be only 1.2 million. Rise did maybe a little over a million, and that was a hack and slash that definitely deserves a sequel. I mean, you know, it was a little repetitive after a while, but just fun, a great hack and slash that you can make it even more. PUBG comes out, it does 4 million, not even within a week. So what does that tell you? You are somebody at Microsoft, and you're looking at the data numbers. Oh, well, they want shooters.
Right.
But then you scream on podcasts, you scream on, you know, main media, whatever, you know what I'm saying? Even in the magazines, my man Andy at Game Informer or something like that, saying that Microsoft doesn't have enough variety. The audience doesn't want the variety. And when you give them the variety, they don't buy it. So what are they supposed to do? What are they supposed to do? And I think that's just unfair by the Xbox community that they're trying to give you different stuff. Like, there was this game that is coming out called Mutant, The End of War, or Road.
What about Biomutant? Like, what about Biomutant? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, and you know what?
And you want to know something, man? What were people, you know, when Microsoft had Halo, man. See, this is the funny part. When Microsoft had Halo, we had that dominant shooter, right? But that dominant shooter wasn't everything, man. We had all kind of diversity in games. So that's why I don't even listen to that, man. Like, that's not what Xbox gaming was about anyway. It was just the shooters, man. The shooters are what's popular. Microsoft is going to cash in on what's popular. That's just the way it is. You're talking about shooters make up, what, 38%? 38% of the gaming
maybe
market?
Even
so,
more. Maybe more.
So,
more. I mean,
that's where you're going to go, man. I mean, but also,
at the same time,
you want to make sure you keep some kind of diversity in your gaming because, honestly,
that's all I'm saying. But if you're the community, you got to support it, man.
Right.
You got to support it. I'm not telling you to buy a game you don't like. Don't think I'm saying that.
Right.
I'm saying that, yeah, well, they give you something different.
Don't be complaining when you... Right.
I
don't even listen to people like that, though, man.
You put out a video on your channel, man, which is really awesome, yo. And anybody that, you know, goes to New League on his YouTube channel, really check this out, man. It was a video where Dorian's talking about how your gaming friend or, you know, your man's or, you know, your people's puts you onto something different. Try it out, man. You might just like it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And that's real. That's, like, real. Like, try something different, man. And, you know, gaming is a hobby, but you got to kind of grow with your hobby. Like, I never liked role-playing games, man. I was intimidated by them. And then one day I sat down, and I really got into, Lost Legacy?
Yeah, I remember you beating that, man. I remember you talking about that.
That was the first Japanese turn-based that was the first one that I played. I really enjoyed it, man. It challenged me, but the story was so awesome. Like, I would love another one, right? So, but that's me opening, you know, broaden my horizons. Like, I mean, dude, like, yeah, it's cool you bouncing off the wall with a shotgun, but it ain't nothing wrong with you racing cars, man. It ain't nothing wrong with you, you know what I mean, going nuts in Sunset Overdrive, man. You're still shooting stuff.
Right.
It's just more cartoony. And what I noticed is with the community is that a lot of them, they're not feeling the cartoony graphics, man. Right? They're not feeling it. They want to get back to the realism. Well, when you do that, you kind of limit yourself as far as demographic, man.
Right.
Because, like, you gotta understand, Phil Spencer said something that was so powerful, man. He said, you know, we take care of our hardcore, right? We take care of our fan base and our core. But you gotta understand, there's gonna be a kid on Christmas morning that's gonna open up a gift, and it's gonna be an right? Why should we be so selfish, right? Right. I remember when I opened up my Nintendo, it was Gyromite and Super Mario Brothers.
Gyromite, yeah, I remember that, yeah.
Right, so why should we be so selfish, man? I tell you sometimes the way the gaming culture, right, the gaming culture sometimes forget that kids play games, man. That's because we're still kids ourselves and we turn our consoles on.
Right.
Kids need games too.
Now, right, we tend to.
That's gonna make people upset.
Right, we tend. Right, we tend to.
Super Lucky Tales, it did almost 2 million copies, man. That's why there's a sequel coming.
That's right.
Exactly.
That's right. That's right, yep. Man. And there's nothing wrong with that. I mean,
there's nothing wrong with it, man.
The big hits right now are not even games. It's services.
Right.
You know, the services that Microsoft is putting out right now is just mind-blowing, man. And all they got to do is just stick to that script, and they'll be all right, because they're controlling their own fate right now more than ever. And they're getting it. They're getting it, man. They're like, you know, I wanted to see Xbox get a little cocky, man, for the first time. Well, not for the first time.
I think they will at E3, man. I think they got some stuff, man, to show, man. And if they're smart, I think Phil Spencer got a lot of new stuff to show. Maybe it don't come to 2019, but some stuff gonna come in the fall, no question, and everything. They showed a lot of games at E3 last year. A lot of those games are coming out pretty much now. Like, you're starting to see it. March, April, May. A lot of those games are gonna come out. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But, yo, I mean, Microsoft understands that, you know, Microsoft understands that, you know, basically, since the game, the world is changing, man. The world is changing, the gaming is changing, man. You know? And you don't want to get caught with your pants down, man. You really don't. Everything can't stay the same forever. You know, I got to understand that, man, that in 10 years, man, in 10 years, you may not be able to walk into a GameStop, man. Like, it's a reality, man. It really could be.
It very much could be, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, I think the thing about gaming, man, to me, the culture of gaming is almost like comic books, man. You can, but it just doesn't have the same effect. Like, digital gaming is different, but there's nothing like picking up a comic book and reading.
And holding it in your hands.
That's right.
Right.
There's some aspects of things that has to be part of the essence. And gaming stores are part of the essence. You get rid of stores like GameStop and all that, you start killing off the essence of gaming. Because we need that place where we can go, we can talk, it's community. You know what I'm saying? You need that, just like you get it on here. So you need both of them. So they don't ever need to get rid of them places. But the thing is, there's always something, there's always some elements to gaming, right? We can always use collectibles.
Right.
We always can do special edition games. Because I'm always for the option. You know, as long as we keep the option fine. And you know what? If digital outsells hard copies one day, look, man, what's the big deal of hard copies having their little space of customers that they'll get? Because they're not you're not going to lose with gaming.
Right. No, I mean, listen, my thing is this, man, is that I totally agree with you. I really do. Unfortunately, we live in a world full of business.
Right.
Okay? And also, it's the simple fact of that, you know, don't get me wrong, man. Like, I used to be that dude, man. I used to be that dude. I'd get off work on Friday. You know what I mean? I took care of my bills. I'm going to go cop me 2 games, you know, whatever. Go get me some Wendy's and some fries and I'm in this motherballing, you know what I'm saying? But the thing is that I realize that gaming culture, it doesn't want to grow. That's what makes me nervous as a gamer.
Right.
Music grew. Movies grew.
Right.
I'm not saying to get rid of physical content. I'm just saying that the whole physical thing is not as important, because the average person, think about make sure GameStop wasn't closed, or you had to wait till the next day. Remember midnight launches?
Yeah, midnight launches was raw, man.
Midnight launches and everything.
That's right.
Right. You're right. That stuff is part of game of essence.
That's right.
100%. And don't get me wrong, man. Like, I would love if Microsoft did a Halo 6 midnight launch. And that'd be awesome, you know, in New York. And kind of give us that nostalgia factor, man, once again. But it's just that the world is changing, man. Like, think about it, right? And I think I talked to you about this before. Why am I paying $60 for Soul Calibur 4? Soul Calibur 6. As a matter of fact, why would I pay $60 for Tekken 7? Just think about what I'm saying.
Right.
You could have threw those on Game Pass and made more money. Be honest with you. You could have threw it on Game Pass. You could have made more money because now more people can play it. You could have added your content and more people would be able to play the game. Because the average person is going to beat the game, and they're going to most people are going to beat the camp, beat a couple characters, and then when something new come out, they're going to take it back to GameStop and trade it in.
Right.
Right? And then Dragon Ball FighterZ, which I love. You know, I think it's an awesome game, man. But it's like, yo, like, I read an article, and I read it again, that now it's lost 80% of its people playing online. And then it's like you look at games like Monster Hunter. Man, yo, like, Monster Hunter kind of became it became the next breath of air after Destiny. Because most people love Monster Hunter. You know, y'all got together, slashing down monsters, and, you know, running around, and every service is becoming a real thing. It really is, man. Where people get together in these worlds. The same thing that Phil Spencer said. You get together in these worlds, and y'all have fun, and you stay in these worlds, man.
Right. Because he was talking about how developers build worlds, you know, and we'll just come together.
That's what it is, man.
That's what gaming is.
Yeah, Nintendo and stuff like that.
I'm in a world right now, man. Crackdown world right now.
Yep. Crackdown. Right now, if we have four people and we all have headsets, we can all run rampant and let loose.
Just
and
go ham.
Because gamers do want to play together. That's what I'm trying to say. And
it's
also,
like blowing up stuff,
know,
man.
People, there's this thing where people, they don't want to play with PC gamers, and that kind of turns them off to Microsoft too, because Microsoft wants to change that culture. Microsoft doesn't care whether you play with PC gamers.
The thing is, what people aren't getting about the PC, man, is that Microsoft is eventually going to make the playing field the same. The goal is to make. That's what people are so stupid, man. They don't get it.
Yeah.
It doesn't benefit you to have a platform weaker than the other one, and you're trying
Thank
to
you.
Push forth an ecosystem that people just stupid. They don't get it. It doesn't happen overnight, idiots. It's gonna take some time. But the thing about it is, you're gonna find a sweet spot between both platforms. You're gonna find that sweet spot, and that's what you're gonna play. You're gonna base your gaming ecosystem off of.
Right, because on Sea of Thieves, you don't know who you're playing with, man. You don't know who getting on your bullets on a PC. You don't know, but who cares?
Right.
And Microsoft is making it seamless, man. That's what they're doing. They're making it seamless, and I love that, man. I love that. And, you know, it's like, you know, my brother told me that when you're a trailblazer, you're going to take a lot of bumps and bruises, right, because you're the first one to do it.
Right.
But that's what Microsoft is doing, man. Like, they see that, you know, it can't just be just console world and, we got our games. No. Everybody plays together, man. Everybody has a chance to play the games, too.
Right.
Because Phil Spencer said something in that DICE speech that blew my mind. He said in 3 years, that'd be 2021, am I right?
Right.
He said there would be over 2.3 billion gamers. My gosh, man.
That's a lot of people, right?
How many exclusives do you think is going to hold that, man?
Right.
How many exclusives do you think is going to hold that? No. So you create these worlds. You create these ecosystems. That's where the gaming industry is going.
Right.
That's where it's going. You still have your single player stuff, but they want people to play together. And they, you know what I mean? They
and
want
see,
to play
the thing about it is, the thing about it is, let's keep it real, right? The PC has some of the most loyal fans to their games, right? And they got the big, they got a big fan base. And I have to give them their respect because PC is what's keeping a lot of these games intact because they continue to do that. And so the gaming industry ain't going to leave games that have a high volume of gamers playing it. And I think that's a good thing because we don't need to get away from that. If you got a fan base that's loyal to a brand for a game, you keep that. You keep that. You don't change that up. You change it up when the gamers are ready to change it up. You listen to them.
Exactly.
So, you know what I'm saying? We laugh at, you know, I'm not big on, Age of Empire
We just said, right? Don't knock it till you try it, right?
Right. These games, man, these people.
I just downloaded Halo Wars, the Definitive Edition.
Right.
Real time strategy. I'm a Halo fan. I'm going to try it out. And then I heard from, I'm going to give him a shout out, man. My man, Kate Mega, Kareem Lowe, you know what I'm saying? The GRG podcast, right? He told me that, yo, they got great stories. And that really, as a Halo fan, I'm kind of lost if I don't know these stories. So it's like, yo, I'm going to try these games out, man. I don't even play real-time strategy, but maybe I can get into this one. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
Because you never know. And, you know, think about Halo, man. It's always been a great story game, but complete action.
Yeah.
With complete action.
That's
so,
the Michael Bay. That's the Michael Bay stuff, the over-the-top stuff. Man, there's nothing better, man. Woo! There's nothing better than jumping in the bungee thing. I think it's called a Banshee.
Oh, that Banshee.
you flying around, man. Oh, man. You just rushing, you just breaking stuff down with the lasers, and you just smashing the Covenant. Gives me a rush, man.
Right.
Gives me a rush. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, so I actually started on that Halo Wars back in the day, man. It does have good. It does have a great story to it, man. It really does.
Yeah, see what I'm saying? So it's like I want to be able to, like, okay, because really, like, Halo 6 is coming, right? So it's like, man, I gotta know exactly what's popping. Like, you know, because everybody told me Halo Wars 2 had a phenomenal story, man.
Yeah, it does, man. If you want to change it up and get into something that you strategy fight, man, that'll get you. Me personally, I did Halo Wars. I did a Halo Assault. So I've been kind of slow on my Halo Wars because I've already done those, and I was just like, you know what? I'll wait a little bit because that's not something that you need to rush on. You don't have to rush on it, man. You can do it.
It's another part of Halo, right? I guess you say, you know, the universe, whatever you want to call it, man. So it's like, it's just, man, my whole thing is like, I just want different gaming experiences, man. Like I would love at E3 if they had something like Rise, a whole new hack and slash, some type of barbaric game, but it's co-op. You know what I'm saying? And y'all taking down, like, dragons and orcs and monsters and, you know, you fighting them type of bandits and stuff and, you know, thieving for gold. Like, that type of stuff gets me excited, man. You know what I'm saying?
I hear you, man.
Yeah.
I hear you. I'm like, man, with all this stuff happening within the last 2 weeks, it's getting me gassed up for E3 because Microsoft is staging itself up for something that I think, man, we're all going to be shocked about, man.
Oh, I think so, too. And I honestly, I'm calling it. I'm with you. I think Anthem going to be insane, man.
Oh,
I think Anthem
man.
Is going to be
That's
going to
be the killer,
again.
Man.
Oh, this is next gen. Whoa. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I think Anthem is going to be nuts, man. I just think that they're smart, man. Take your time with it, man. Take your time with it. Like, you know, sometimes these companies, man, me and my boy was talking, my best friend in the world, man, my boy William. He was like, yo, he loved Rockstar, man. Because Rockstar would tell you to go shut the F up. We gonna put our game out, we wanna put it out.
No, that's true,
and
man.
That's how
they
every
don't...
company should be. Every company should be like that. Every company should not fall to the media and the IGNs and, you know, whatever cats got YouTube channels and, you know, whatever it is, man. You put your
that
game out
true.
When you're ready to put your game out, man.
Yup.
That's how it used to be. But you know what, Dorian? It all started with Mass Effect 3. I take you back. It all started with Mass Effect 3, where people didn't like the ending, and they lost their mind, man. I mean, it was a straight explosion of nerds that didn't like Mass Effect 3 ending, right? So that was the first time, man, that with the community and its voice and YouTube and online and all this stuff, man, they went and changed the ending. What they do that for,
there,
man?
Right.
Like,
Far Cry 5 is going to be big, man.
Yeah,
shout
man.
Out to all
they
the Far Cry
be
5 fans out there.
Shooter,
because that game is
going
to be
like,
a nice treat for you guys, man. And everybody that's been following that series, man. Especially from 3 to 4, you know.
Yeah, 3 was a masterpiece. I played Far Cry 1, which was cool. I never played Far Cry. I don't think I played Far Cry 2. I don't know if that's the one you're in Africa. I think I saw that backwards compatibility. But Far Cry 3 was a masterpiece. An absolute game changer. A lot of stuff games do now because of Far Cry 3. A
right,
lot of stuff.
Right.
Yep. But, I mean, yeah, man, I just think that developers should have their vision, man. I don't think you should have a say how the game should be made. Let the developer have their vision. Let the developer
right.
take you on a ride, man. Let them take you on a ride.
Right. They the ones that are making the game. I see
yeah.
what you're saying. They the ones making the game. You appreciate it or not, you know.
Exactly.
Nobody's making
exactly.
you buy the game. I see what you're saying. Okay.
Exactly, man.
Right.
You know what I mean? So it's like, you know, I just think that's what gaming is at its best, man, when you let the developer do what they want to do.
Well, I mean,
you know what I mean?
It, was it always like that in the beginning, right? You didn't go to the arcades. Demanding that this arcade game was, you know, to fit your satisfaction, man. Come on, man. I mean, have we gotten to that part being that daggone weak as gamers?
I mean, yo, man.
Crybabies and stuff?
Mass Effect 3 changed the industry as far as, like, the voice of gamers and you know, kind of a lot of the toxic stuff that Phil's talking about, man, where it's like, yo, it's cool to have a voice, but you don't understand that you're being selfish, man. Like, you know, it's cool you want this, but that's not the vision, man.
Right.
Your $60 don't mean that much. No disrespect. For just $60, even if you go buy the collector's edition, it's been $250. It don't mean that much.
Right.
Let them develop the game the way they want to. Straight up. You know what I mean? So, I just think that, you know, that's what makes gaming magical, man. Like, when we go off of the developer's vision. Man, if this game mechanics is something that, you know, sucks, yeah, I understand. I get it. You know what I mean? Like, because one thing I hated about Rise was like, yo, I'm going to lose my lunch. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But I understood that, you know, it was just a launch game, man. It was trying something new. But, yeah,
that's
man,
true.
I mean, you know,
that's
creativity
true.
And gaming here. Creativity and gaming is needed right now, man. Like, it really needs to go away from copy and paste really need some new ideas, and even if you take a new old idea and make it better, I want that. You know what I'm saying? Like,
right.
And nothing wrong with that. Like, I'm still looking for a new Streets of Rage, man. So, Sega, if you hear me, can I get a new Streets of Rage? It could be $20 on Xbox Live. Please.
Yeah, that's true, man. I blew myself up, man. But, yeah, man, it's just getting real now, man, and if we as Xbox fans now are at a place now, man, where we got all the diversity we need, we got a good supply of back cap compatibility games, we got
the backwards compatibility game, right now, Microsoft is the Tony Montana of backwards compatibility. Nobody can mess with them.
Nah, man, we got 3 exclusives coming out, man, for the year. All of them are bringing something different to the table.
Exactly.
Sea of Thieves is gonna be an instant hit, man. State of Decay 2 is gonna be the next big thing, man. I see just number sales out the roof with that one, man.
Yep.
It's not even gonna be funny, and I can't wait, man. What's the other one? Crackdown 3. And it's just right now, man, I really don't have nothing to complain about. I'm just having fun, man.
Me neither.
I have nothing to complain about.
Nothing, man. I think if more people were actually playing their games, man, I think it'd be less to complain about, man.
Exactly.
I just think that, yo, go play your games, man. Go be something, man. Yeah?
That's
Show
true.
Me some end credits, man.
That's true.
Do that for me.
That's
just
true,
come,
man.
Go show me some end credits, man. Please. Do that for me.
Right.
If somebody do that for me.
You can only,
show me some
you're
end
right,
credits.
Man, because you can only deal with the silly stuff for so long, man. I mean,
yeah, man.
The silly
yeah,
stuff
man.
Is
you
just silly,
just,
man. I,
you
know. I know it
yeah,
has an
yeah,
audience.
Man.
I know
be
the silly.
Be about it, man. Just be about it. That's all I'm saying.
Right, man.
Man.
You know, everybody's got to have their audience, man. I'm not a silly type of dude, man. I don't get into the silly stuff with anything, man. So
yeah, no doubt.
I can't get into it, man. You know what I'm saying? I just honor with what I do and what the news I try to bring out. We try to bring what we talk about every day within our community. I don't try to fabricate nothing else. And I just like to have a good talks, man, and see what everybody else thinks about what we talk about. I mean,
yeah,
we actually do this. This is something that we actually get into parties. We do this on Xbox. So, I mean, it's not like we're not doing anything that we're just going out of our element, man. We do this for real. So, why not use a platform that represents what we do the best, you know?
I mean, hey, we gamers, man. You know what I'm saying?
That's
this
right,
is,
man.
This is pretty much part of our lives, man. Like, you know, I think that for me, man, like, gaming, man, like, it's real for me. And my boys, like, get me out of gangs, man. I ain't never sell drugs or nothing like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, we was arcade kids. We was console kids, man. We wasn't worrying about them. You know what I'm saying? Like, we was worried about, you know. But then it's like, man, like, I've seen gaming change people's lives, man. Like, that was in the streets or that was, you know, doing some wild stuff, man. Like, how they found something to be more center and you know, also meeting people, man. Like, man, I'm glad I met you, bro. Like, you're like another brother to me, man. You know what I'm saying? So it's
we folks, man.
It's just a simple fact. Yeah, man, it's just a simple fact of, like, you meet, you know, great minds think alike. You know what I'm saying? So I'm glad we're doing this show. I want a culture, man, where we talk about the great things about Xbox, man. That's what I want to build. A great culture where we talk about the great things about Xbox. Like, hey, man, Sega sat down with the, you know, they was up in Washington, man. You know, having, you know, 2 cup of drinks, sandwiches, and they making deals, baby.
That's
you
right.
You know what I mean? They making deals. Like, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, yo, man, I know for me, man, and I get that same vibe from you. Gaming makes you excited, man. Makes you excited.
Of course, man.
And that's how I felt. Like, I saw that Red Rogers, I was like, oh, yeah, I'm copying this, man. As soon as it came on, man.
You went on
like,
and got
yeah,
it.
Man.
Yeah, man.
I played
just
the Joker for like 3 hours, man. I got to level 3. You know what I'm saying? It's just that I think that gaming should just be fun. You know what I'm saying? Like, if I buy a Switch, right? I'm just saying, if I went and bought a Switch, it's because I want to have fun. Like, I'm in the mood for something different. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I just think gaming should be about fun. And I think sometimes people, man, they make it a little bit too much. I'm not singling nobody. I'm talking about the industry.
Right.
I think they make it more than what it needs to be. Like, we don't need a TMZ of gaming, yo. We don't
exactly.
need that.
Exactly. Bro, it's so funny, right? It's hilarious, man, when you
that's
think about it. You stupid,
into,
man. My man said a TMZ
into,
of gaming.
Yeah, TMZ of gaming, man. You know what I'm saying? That's what they want, you know? Like, oh, Aaron Greenberg fell off his chair today.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They, that's what they want to do. They don't even
want to
talk about games no more, man.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
So true, man. It's funny,
it's
man.
True.
Soap opera, some All My Children stuff, man.
Yep. Yeah. Yep.
It's hilarious,
man.
It's hilarious.
And it's like, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, man, I just want the community to be strong. I want people to enjoy their games. Play games you never played before, man. Like, yo, go get that Game Pass, man. I don't work for Microsoft, man. But I'm promoting it. Go get that Game Pass. $10.
Oh, man, Game Pass is,
games,
Game Pass is the real deal, man.
Wild out.
Yeah, Game Pass is the real deal, man.
It is, man. They added 8 new games, man. They added the Rise of the Tomb Raider with the Xbox One, you know, X enhancements. If you never played Rise of the Tomb Raider and you bought an Xbox One X, you need to go download that game now. If you have a 4K TV, my gosh, the HDR and everything, it is mind-blowing, man. Mind-blowing. I mean, you got Eurofishing, Super Lucky Tales. They put like 4 different episodes of Resident Evil Reservation, so you got some episodic content. It's getting better, man. It really is, man.
Right.
So it's like, you know, Game Pass, man, it's just, it's really good, man. I mean, like, I found this one cool game called Skyforge. It's like this, I guess you could say it's like 1942, if you remember that game by Capcom.
Yeah, I remember 1942. Yeah, 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 exactly.
Skyforge is really good, man. It's just a lot of fun. I just think that we should accept all the avenues, man, whether it's Game Pass, you know what I mean? We just can't stick to what I want to go buy, what I want to buy, and screw everything else. There's different avenues for ways to use the game. Accept it, man. Digital as well as physical. Because it all benefits the industry, man. I'm happy when Sony does well. I'm happy when Microsoft does well. I'm more happy when Nintendo's doing well. Because it means the industry is healthy, man.
Yeah.
Healthy. Yo, I would really, like, punch a hole through a wall if I ever heard there was a game crash again, man.
Well, you know, Sega went bye-bye. The way I look at it is the gaming industry always rebounds, right? Sega went bye-bye. And you don't hear nobody, you know, thinking about it is, that's part of it, man. If you can't hang with the big...
Exactly, yo. You're right. You're definitely right, man. So it's like, I just want the gaming industry to be healthy, man. And just, you know, I'm so excited, man, for State of Decay. I'm gonna probably play the first one, but the second one looks insane, and it's 4 players at the same time, you know. So you can really get that Walking Dead experience and and everything. So it's like Microsoft is providing so much variety, man. I think people are just kind of like, you know, they kind of like, you know, it's crazy. I'm gonna make you laugh, Dorian. I think a lot of gamers, man, they like gaming to be like Jordans. Would you agree?
I think you're right on that, man. I think you're right on that.
That makes sense, right?
That makes plenty.
You got your off-white Jordans. You got this. You got the different special editions. But they all look like the same sneaker.
Right.
So I mean, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, yo, I just think that, yo, man, appreciate what Microsoft does, and everything is gonna be better. Everything is gonna turn a corner. Everything is gonna be much more big bang for your buck. Way more variety. If you're an Xbox fan, you should be excited right now, man. You should be excited.
You're right, man.
Yeah. worrying about the marketing, man. You know, stop worrying about what they make. You know, stop worrying about what's going up in the boardrooms. Stop, you know what I mean? Like, play games, man. Like, stop trying to get at these people on Twitter. Like,
you
too much, man.
Grown in men.
It's funny. Check this out. You got 200 games in backlog, but you trying to yell at Phil Spencer and Mike Ybarra all day on Twitter. You trying to be a fanboy. Like, come on, B. Like, get a life, man. You know what I'm saying? They're making big boy moves, man. This is entertainment. I think we need to understand to keep it that way.
You're right, man. Just keep it gaming. Man. Keep it gaming, and you ain't got nothing to worry about.
Exactly. Stop worrying about other stuff, man. Like, a lot of people just... I understand it's your favorite platform, but... No, man, just game, man. Just have fun, man. Just enjoy. There's some great games, great stories... great entertainment, great content. It's something for everybody, man.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But I think sometimes, man, I'm just looking at the gaming culture. Like I said, TMZ of gaming, man. TMZ. That's what everybody want to be now. They want to be TMZ. That's what they want, man.
Now you're killing me with that.
So-and-so got fired today. So-and-so got fired today from Microsoft.
Who did?
At the end of the
Oh,
Xbox.
Yeah. Who did?
You know what I'm saying? It's ridiculous, man.
And then it'll be like 30 of them doing the same show. It's funny, man.
Yeah, if you go to YouTube, everybody has to make a video. Everybody about the same thing that happened, man.
Like, hey, man, it's all...
It's just like, man...
It's all good, man. It's all good, man.
Yeah, but that's not gaming culture, man. You know what I mean? Gaming culture is playing games.
It's all good, man. Hey, man. Yeah. You know what? It's up to you to search the city. It's all good, man.
It is, man. I just laugh at some of the funny stuff, man.
Yeah, you just gotta laugh at some of that stuff, man.
The good stuff, man. The good stuff. Hey, I got my crackdown back, man. I'm jumping buildings. I'm grabbing orbs. I'm shooting gangs up. Man, I'm in heaven.
Yeah, I hear you, man. And what's your prediction for this fall, man? What would you like to see for the fall of Xbox, man?
Oh man.
What do you think? What do you think should be a fall game for Xbox, man?
I'm gonna say it right now, man. I think that Shadow of the Tomb Raider comes out this fall. I think Microsoft got the exclusive for a year.
Hey man, you know what? That's impressive. That's very impressive, man. I didn't even think about that one.
I'm gonna make that prediction. I know we're getting. I think Forza Horizon 4 is going to be anything that we ever expected. I think it's going to be mind blowing. Like it's going to be. If you thought Forza Horizon 3 was great, 4 is just going to blow your mind. I think Microsoft got some stuff up their sleeve, man. I think there's going to be two big new AAAs that come this fall. They're going to show at E3 that we don't even know about. I think one may be a familiar, you know, rebooted.
Right.
And I think that one going to be a total new IP. You know what I'm saying? I just think that this fall is going to be big. I mean, you got Red Dead Redemption 2 coming out October 26th. I can't wait for that.
All these games are going to look better on the X, bottom line. They're going to run better,
better. Bottom line. We 4K Mafia, man.
Right, bottom line, man.
Can't go back. But, so, you know, the best, I'm buying my version of the X, too, man, you know what I'm saying? But, what else, man? I got this feeling, man. I think Ori and the Blind Forest, Ori and the Will of the Wisps, I think that comes out this year.
I think it is, too, man. I think that game might come out in the summer. That would be a good
summer
game.
Or maybe August or something like that.
I think that's
going to come out. I just think that I think there's gonna be a lot of surprises about Microsoft, man. You know, I heard Aaron Greenberg and Mike Ball and them cats say like, "Yo, we hear you." Like, you know what I'm saying? When people saying, "Oh, Xbox ain't got no games," like they hear you, they working. I always tell people this: when Microsoft is not talking, big thing.
Right.
That's a great thing. And the last time they wasn't talking, we got the Xbox One X.
That's true.
And they came out of nowhere with that Scorpio. Like, we couldn't believe it. Like, wait a minute, is this real?
Yeah, that's true, man.
Who introduced two new consoles, man? That was gangster, man. That was just gangster.
That was, man.
It was.
So, yo, General.
And it's still E3.
So, yo, General, man, as we wind this show down, what's one of the games you're mostly anticipated for 2018, man? What's the Xbox game that you want to see?
Wow. Be honest with you, I really want to see Rocksteady. I've heard through the grapevine they're working on a Superman game.
Okay.
Superman is one of, they did such a phenomenal job with Batman, yo. I heard they're working on a Superman game, so if I can get a great Superman game, I'm good, man. The N64 Superman still give me nightmares, man.
Right.
That game was real. Yeah. And next to E.T., that's the worst game ever in gaming history, man. Yeah. But, yeah, man, and like I said, if I can get a Ninja Gaiden,
that'd be off the chain. That'd be off the
man.
Chain.
If I get a Ninja Gaiden, man, I'm just the ugliest girl you can find, yo. That's
how happy I'll be. I'm sick, niggas, man. Well, listen, man. I think we, for episode one.
Yeah.
I'm on a cheer mode right now. We doing big things, man. And I'm glad this went down and we made it official. We're going to keep continuing to bring great positive Xbox news, good talks, man, while we game. And I appreciate anybody that comes in, man, leaves a comment, really, on the direct talk segment. We really take a lot of passion in bringing good news while we're gaming, talking about things that we would just normally talk about, like I said, and party chats. We want to use this platform to demonstrate that. And demonstrate the good high volume of just good class Xbox gaming, man. Nothing out of the unusual. And so with that, man, we're going to get up out of here. This has been Direct Talk, Episode 1, with my man General Johnson. Yo, thanks for making this official with me, man. I appreciate you a lot. I appreciate your commentary, your thoughts on things considering the Xbox community. And, man, let's just keep it rolling, man. Any shout-outs, any final thoughts you want to make, man?
Hey, man, Xbox is good all the time, man. And just keep on gaming, baby. Just keep on gaming. Have fun gaming, man. Just, like I said, man, play some games, man. You got Game Pass, man. Just whatever, man. Just enjoy gaming. I know a lot of y'all got a backlog, man. Go beat some games, man. Go beat some games, man. Become gamers, man. Yeah, that's what gaming is about. We beat games. I'm out. General.
Yo. If you like this show, man, you see that subscribe button below? You can hit that bad boy if you want, man, and instantly you might just get $1 million. If not, man, it's all good. Some people don't like to gamble. You can leave a comment below. Hey, man, you can put a like. You can put a dislike. Yo, General, hold on, man. Hold on. I got this. Hold on. Do whatever you feel. But in the meantime, me and General, we're going to keep talking this direct. This has been Direct Gaming. This is yours, truly, the new legal. And, yo, until next time, you guys have a good day. A good evening, and to all y'all around in the Xbox community, double salute. We out of here.